Hi everyone, good afternoon. Very cloudy one. Let me show up over here. Okay. Welcome once again to Cine con Perspectiva. Bienvenido nuevamente a Cine con Perspectiva. This is another video for Cine con Perspectiva. Esto es nuevamente un video para Cine con Perspectiva. This is gonna be without music. I'm sorry. Let me see if I can put some music here. Okay, now we are in theme, people, so that it wouldn't be so like. Okay. Well, we hear this zombie background. I'm gonna update you as to the latest buzz going news about Star Wars. Los voy a actualizar sobre las noticias más que están resonando mucho en la internet y que he oído hablar. Tómelo con un tanto de escepticismo. Take this with a grain of salt. But this is what I've been hearing is going to be like for episode 9 by J.J. Abrams, and the script co-written with Chris Terrio. Okay, so here we go. Let's dive into it right away with this very beautiful background over here about Star Wars per se. So okay, first of all, this caught my attention immediately. Luke Skywalker, this is the headline, Luke Skywalker will be de-aged for episode 9. Mark Hamill is returning to shoot, is going to travel to London Penguin Studios in September, in about a month or so, to shoot scenes for Star Wars episode 9. One of them is going to be him, Daisy Ridley, and Adam Driver in a scene. This is what I've heard, okay? So according to this bit, which I've heard somewhere, this is like the first shot or scene they're going to do with Mark Hamill returning as Jedi Master Luke Skywalker. Let's hope they do bring him back in a good fashion. We don't know if they're going to revive him or use him in a forced ghost kind of fashion, but this is some of the things I've been hearing. Comment below what you think about what you are hearing right now. Another thing that I've been hearing is that they're going to de-age Luke Skywalker, which is pretty much to help you understand it. Remember, this is a reference, okay? Remember, I don't know if you remember Avengers Civil War, the very first minute, within the first minutes of Civil War, you saw a very young Robert Downey Jr. Along with his parents, and you saw this was John Tony Stark having a moment with his parents. They used this kind of like reflection kind of thing right before his parents left somewhere and ended up the way they did. So anywho, this is another thing which I heard. The same thing was done for Michael Douglas in the Ant-Man movies. They did this in Ant-Man 1, in Ant-Man 2 for Michael Douglas, and they're actually going to do it again and try it with great amount of effort again for Mark Hamill as Luke Skywalker. You're hearing that they want to de-age him, I think they call this term like that. They're going to do some kind of digital CGI rearrangement of something, do some kind of CGI. Let me take out my glasses so you can see me clearly. Yes, they're going to do some kind of CGI magic on him, some sort. It seems like they're going to do this to Mark Hamill so that it can repeat again, use this necessarily for story-wise purposes in the film. Mark Hamill tweeted something very elusive about it, referring also to his dog, which he takes just about any movie he shoots. You can check out his Twitter. I can't found that tweet, but supposedly that's Mark Hamill foreshadowing, saying that he's going to London to shoot Star Wars Episode 9, which, according to what I've heard, he's going to begin shooting his scenes in September. One of them is going to be, the first ones are going to be between him, Daisy Ridley as Rey, and Adam Driver as Kylo Ren. Okay? Those one of the things. The other thing which I've heard about Star Wars news lately is that they want to do a kind of well, you see, they say that Star Wars, the whole saga, has to rhyme. They want to do so. What I'm trying to tell you is that what I've heard is that they're trying to do this thing where it rhymes, where it's similar, to say it in a different way. To seem similar to the, to Return of the Jedi, where they did this very walk the plank in a ship scene. Remember that one, Return of the Jedi, where Han Solo, Luke, and Chewie would walk the plank in a ship, in a flying ship, which was Jabba's barge, or whatever they call it, his ship, and they were going to throw them at a monster or something like that. And who ended up being swallowed was Boba Fett, as you know. So that kind of thing again, but not per se like they did within this inside this spaceship or ship or whatever they call it, in a bad guy kind of way. But instead of that, it's going to be in a ship within a good guy spaceship, which is in this case for Lupita Nyong'o's character, Maz Kanata. Okay, she's gonna have a ship, and she's gonna fly it. She's gonna be the captain probably, and they're going to fly away in it through Jakku. This is interesting. They're returning to Jakku, and the previous news, you will hear, see the video link over here, is that, like I said in the previous video, they want to return to Jakku. They want to reuse Jakku again, but the interesting thing is they want to use a certain location, try to use it again. They tried to do it for episode 7, they couldn't for some reason, logistically speaking probably, and now they're going to try to finally use that location. I think it's called Jordan, to finally use it as a location for episode 9 in this case. So also remember that J.J. Abrams, and that has been said once again, after time, they want to use all references from all the saga, from episodes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, exactly. So that's some of the news. Also that they're going to use spaceships that are going to look like other spaceships in other parts of the saga, especially these classic ones, things like that. So anywho, that's a whole lot of the things that I've been hearing. Also that they're going to use footage never before used in the sequel trilogy, shot with Carrie Fisher, approved by her daughter Billy Lord and her brother. So those are the news that I've been hearing about lately, and who knows, these might be actually true. Take them with a certain kind of skepticism. Así que miren las noticias. Ah, ya van 9 minutos. Okay. Van a rejuvenecer a Luke Skywalker. ¿Cómo? Solo recuerden que en la última película de Ant-Man y la avispa hicieron esta cuestión, que no sé si notaron, pero es un truco digital que es rejuvenecer a un actor como Michael Douglas, que ya está como en sus 60, corríjame si me equivoco, y van a usar algo que hicieron también, pues lo hicieron también con Robert Downey Jr. en Capitán América Guerra Civil, donde vimos a un joven Tony Stark al lado de sus papás antes de que partieran y les pasara lo que les pasó. Y las otras dos referencias son de Michael Douglas en Ant-Man 1 y Ant-Man 2, donde lo rejuvenecieron para verse como un joven Hank Pym. Y esas son las tres referencias de donde han usado y aplicado la tecnología de rejuvenecimiento digital, digámoslo en esos términos. Y quieren hacerlo para Luke Skywalker. Pues resulta interesante porque se hablan de flashbacks. This I want, I forgot to mention, but they want to use some. There's been rumors that they want to use the digital rejuvenation thing, which I'm telling you in Spanish, to rejuvenate Luke for a flashback or two, having to do with Kylo Ren and Leia and Han in some kind of way, some kind of fashion, as a flashback. Así que bueno, esto podría ser para un flashback también, el rejuvenecimiento digital de Luke. También decía que Mark Hamill en su Twitter, en algún, búsquenlo bien, no tienen que buscar mucho. Él escribió que hizo un poquito como diciendo sutilmente que ya en septiembre se va a filmar sus escenas para episodio 9. Se cree que va a ser una fantasma, como fantasma de la fuerza. También se dice que va a ser escenas de flashback, donde vamos a verlo recibir a un joven Ben Solo, antes de ser Kylo Ren, y va a estar Leia y Han Solo. También se dice, pues más bien que va a ser para unos flashbacks, más bien. ¿Qué más? También de una nave, como la escena del regreso del Jedi. Quieren hacer esta cosa donde riman unos episodios con los clásicos y ese rollo. Algo así como hacer algo similar, es decir, hacer algo similar como lo que hicieron en el regreso del Jedi, donde estaban en la nave de Jabba, donde los iba a tirar hacia un monstruo, iban a darse un clavado y acabar en la boca de un monstruo que los iba a regurgitir y digerir. Bueno, una cosa asquerosa por miles de años, y el que acabó digerido fue Boba Fett, pero pues se supone que ya no. En fin, bueno, es una referencia, pero eso es lo que yo he oído resonar mucho en la internet, y es precisamente que quieren hacer una escena similar, pero de una manera positiva, que sería en un barco espacial, el barco espacial, o sea, de más que nada, cuyo personaje lo hace Lupita Nyong'o, una paisana mexicana y una actriz muy muy buena. Y bueno, ¿qué más? Caramba, que van a usar escenas inéditas que jamás usaron para el episodio 7 ni 8, para armar, montar, hacer un montaje de escenas, no sabemos de qué forma o de qué manera, pero escenas jamás utilizadas en los episodios 7 y 8, para hacer un montaje en la edición y con otros artilugios cinematográficos para incluir una manera muy, muy, más que simbólica, más bien muy significativa, importante y pues importante a la generala Leia, o también conocida como princesa Leia. También una más noticia más, es que se rumora, bueno, es más, casi aseguran que están haciendo scouting de locaciones en Caserta, Italia, donde hicieron escenas para el episodio El ataque de los clones. Quieren, parece ser, regresar ahí. Se especula que quieren hacer algo muy significativo. Tal vez se rumora, están especulando que podrían ser escenas finales donde a lo mejor entierren a la princesa, pues muere la princesa Leia de una manera importante y pues poética, y por ser más poética y rimar de algún modo con las películas clásicas, episodios 4, 5 y 6, 1, 2 y 3, pues enterrar a Leia, una vez que haya muerto poética y heroicamente, enterrarla en donde vive su madre, junto a su madre, que es, pues, es ni nada más ni nada menos que la princesa y senadora Padme Amidala. Así era una película bien redonda, como lo pretende ambiciosamente la visión de J.J. Abrams y Chris Terry, quien coescribió el guión. Así que bueno. Also, I'm hearing that they want to shoot in Caserta, Italy, to do scenes. It is speculated that they want to do scenes in which you can see Leia being her body being carried somehow, some way, to shoot a scene where you can have a funeral scene in which they take Leia all the way to where her mother, her biological mother, is buried. Because anywho, her adopted mother died when they blew up Alderaan in episode, all the way back in episode 4. So they can't actually use Alderaan as to where they actually bury Leia. They're going to, this is speculated that they're going to probably kill Leia in 9 and even do a very significant, beautiful scene where they end up burying Leia along, side by side with her mother, who we know, of course, is Padme Amidala, General and Senator Padme Amidala. So that's the other news I've been hearing about. Take it with a grain of salt. Sean un poco escépticos, pero son fascinantes estas noticias. Ya 19 minutos. No, 15. Bien. So this was the short video which I pretty much gathered together about the latest trends on Star Wars. So estas son las noticias más recientes sobre Star Wars. Van a surgir cosas, hay estas cosas sobre la serie de acción, live action de por Jon Favreau, que dicen que ya, casi la tiene lista. So, many Star Wars news going on, muchos de Star Wars pasando. Nos vemos en el próximo video, y may the Force be with you always. Once again, happy birthday Ian McDiarmid, feliz cumpleaños Ian McDiarmid, hoy. Recuerden, cumpleaños Ian McDiarmid, tiene cuenta de Twitter, búsquelo como Ian McDiarmid. Feliciten al emperador Palpatine si lo quieren. So, please congratulate Ian McDiarmid on his birthday. Happy birthday, Emperor Palpatine. Ian McDiarmid, happy birthday on your birthday. And may the power of the dark side be you always. So this was my effort to do an impression on Palpatine, and well, happy birthday, Ian McDiarmid. Here you go. But I am not a Sith. I'm a great Jedi. Okay, soy un Jedi gris. Así que don't take that for granted. Así que bueno, nos vemos en el próximo video, y may the Force be with you always. Ciao.